Hello and welcome to Talk FCB and welcome here to the Copa del Rey final preview. We are going to be going through Barcelona against Sevilla coming up this Saturday in the Copa del Rey final. It is our chance to win our fourth successive Copa del Rey crown. Can we do it? We are going to find out. As always, guys, the video is coming to you today courtesy of the One Football app, which you can find in the description down below. And on the One Football app, it's actually a lot closer than it usually is when it comes to Barcelona. It's very much 50-50 right now, just about in Barcelona's favour. 56% of people believe that Barcelona will win. But if you are on the One Football app, guys, get voting in Barca's favour, because on my own poll, you are all much, much more confident. A lot of people think we've got this one in the bag. A lot of people think we're going to win in 90 minutes, and a lot of you as well believe that we could end up winning this one by 2+ goals. I'll be coming on to my prediction later, but I am also in confident mood here. As always, guys, these are the kickoff times right around the world for Saturday's match, and it is quite a late kickoff, to be honest, in the Copa del Rey, as we have seen right throughout the season so far. The Copa games are often on later. 9:30 local time is going to be the time in Madrid where this game will be kicking off. Atletico Madrid's Wanda Metropolitano Stadium will be hosting this cup final, and not for the first time, Madrid will be well and truly there for the taking. Barcelona can triumph in the capital city. And this, of course, is Ernesto Valverde's chance to win his first trophy as the Barcelona coach, and he could actually be celebrating the title very shortly after the Copa del Rey final too, because following yesterday's game, Atletico against Sociedad, and it was a very surprising big loss on the night for Atletico Madrid. They lost 3-0 at San Sebastian to Real Sociedad, and if they were to lose again on Sunday against Real Betis, if results go in our favour, we could be celebrating the cup final on the Saturday, and then possibly the La Liga crown on Sunday to seal a domestic double on the same weekend, ladies and gentlemen. But onto the game itself. Firstly, as always, we're going to discuss our opposition, of which Sevilla, to be honest, are extremely difficult to categorise. It's very difficult to sort of say whether they're a very top team, whether they're a mid-tier team. Under Montella, they have been extremely unpredictable. From one week to the next, they've been brilliant sometimes. Sometimes they look like real world beaters at times. They went to Old Trafford and beat United, of course. They advanced to the quarterfinals of the Champions League, and even then in those games against Bayern, they didn't really get fully outclassed. They held their own at times against Bayern Munich, but there's also times, you know, in the league this season where they have genuinely looked like a bottom half side, really struggling, leaking goals at the back, very poorly organised, and that's being generous really. They've been on the end of some really, really heavy beatings in La Liga. 4-0 to Celta Vigo very, very recently. They went down to Real Betis in the massive Seville derby. That was a really big defeat for them. 5-1 they lost to little old Eibar, and they conceded 5 goals against both Atletico and Real Madrid. And the list goes on. Really, for Sevilla this season, it's been one week brilliant. The next week, they forgot everything they were doing in the previous week. And going back to that famous win of theirs at Old Trafford, which was in the second week of March, they have not won since that game. In 7 games in all competitions since that game that they won at Old Trafford, they have been without a single victory to their name. They've drawn 4 times in that time period. They've also lost 3 of those, and this, to be honest, is really not a Sevilla side coming into this game with a lot of confidence. They are down right now, they're hurting, but as we've seen before, Sevilla can come out of these things very, very quickly, and we can't underestimate them. We can't afford to say this Sevilla side are clearly lacking in confidence, they're clearly not at a good level right now, because they can turn it on at any moment. They lost to Alaves 1-0 3 days before they went to the Wanda Metropolitano in the same stadium and beat Atletico Madrid, then knocked them out of the Copa del Rey. So we need to be giving them our full attention, making sure that we're fully focused. You can't underestimate this side, but you have to look at what they've done this season, Sevilla, right throughout the season. They're not a consistent side, and they are there for the taking, providing that we turn up. Of Sevilla's strengths and weaknesses, one player you want to be keeping an eye on, guys, is Clement Longley, the Sevilla centre-back, 22 years old,
Frenchman. He has been heavily linked with a move to Barcelona, potentially this summer. He has a 30 million euro release clause. And quite coincidentally, really, in the build-up to this game just a few days before, now we're seeing a lot of rumours linking him with Barcelona. Whether it's just paper talk or not, we don't know. But it will be interesting to see how he fares in this game, how he deals with the likes of Messi and Suarez, and whether he is good enough and ready to play for Barcelona.
And you've only really got to look at our last meeting against Sevilla when you really do realise the kind of threat that they have. The 2-2 draw, of course, at the Ramon Sanchez-Pizjuan at the end of last month should have ended very differently in truth. Sevilla should have won that game. They dominated the game for very large periods. They missed so many chances in front of goal. They were really, really wasteful. And if it wasn't for Lionel Messi coming off the bench and producing yet another miracle, it probably would have ended our league unbeaten run. But of course, we do have that man. We do have a lot more tools as well. And we can do this. Now we will be moving on to Barcelona, to Lionel Messi. Because for me, this is a very different team to what we saw in that game at the Ramon Sanchez-Pizjuan. And it all comes down to me, to that rest that we had against Celta Vigo. Valverde finally decided to rotate it. He finally gave those players a bit of a break. And I think that is going to be massively beneficial ahead of this game in the final. Because look, you know, we all know that we have the players to win. We've got the quality in our squad. We've got the depth. We want to bring players off the bench. We know that we have what it takes to win this final against the Sevilla side. Just like we knew the same. We knew we could get past Roma. We knew we had the quality to get past Roma in the Champions League. But at this stage of the season, it's all about condition. It's all about the way that you arrive into these games, how the players are feeling, if they're ready to go there, to be hungry for success, if they can really motivate themselves to go out there and get what they need to do. And I think tomorrow night we will see a very different team, and I think we'll see a freshness about Barcelona. These players here have had a really good week. They've had a lot of rest, they've had some recuperation time, they've got mentally ready now for this game, and I think going into this, we are going to see a good Barcelona. I hope that we see an attacking approach from Valverde. I hope we see him say, you know what, go for this one. Let's prove to people that I have got it what it takes, that I can control these players, that I do still have the dressing room. And that brings us on to what I think Valverde will do tomorrow and the team that he will face to go out and win this cup final. And as always, guys, we will start right from the back with these team selections, and that starts with Jasper Cillessen, who has been the cup goalkeeper all season long, and it is not expected to change in this game. It is believed that Cillessen will come in and play this final for Barcelona. Then Jordi Alba along the back. Sergio Roberto is eligible to play this game. He got sent off against Celta Vigo, but that only applies to the league, and he is all fine to play in this final. Then at the back is Samuel Umtiti alongside Gerard Pique. Both of those rested against Celta, and I think there are two players there who really did need that rest. They should be mentally ready now. Hopefully we can cut out the mistakes that we've seen from both of those two in the past few weeks and see both of them, the world-class players they are, at their best level. Sergio Busquets is expected to be fit and return in midfield, as also is Ivan Rakitic, who had hand surgery, and he is the one really who's a bit touch and go right now. He's been in training, he's been recovering well, they've really wrapped him in cotton wool to be ready for this one, but it is expected that he will return to Valverde's lineup. Andres Iniesta could be playing and is expected to be playing his last final with Barcelona. I really do hope we give him a good send-off here and win this one for that legend of the club. Then it's Coutinho, Lionel Messi and Luis Suarez in what is expected to potentially be a front three. Valverde in this game, according to some Spanish sources, believe that he might go 4-3-3. He might play the trusted trio in midfield. We know what Busquets, Rakitic and Iniesta can do. And then up front, Suarez, Messi and Coutinho. I think they're all interchangeable. You might see Suarez come central. You might see Messi drop in. Coutinho could play just off Suarez. We've seen their combination, not only at Liverpool, but also now developing at Barcelona. But I think also, you look at this formation, especially with Coutinho out on the right-hand side here. This is the lineup that Sport had in their paper from Valverde. It could also quite easily, though, turn to a 4-4-2 formation. You could have Iniesta out here. You could bring Busquets into the centre. And then you could bring Coutinho out here onto the right-hand side. And Coutinho, to be honest, on the right, it's not his favourite position. But in the past few games, he's been really, really good when he's in the team. And he is expected to earn a start over Ousmane Dembele, who will once again in this one be left on the bench. It is expected. But we'll be talking a lot more about the team and also Sevilla's lineup in my tactical preview, which will also be coming up today, guys, as we build up to this Copa del Rey final. So that is all from me with regard to the match preview, guys. Like I said, I will have more videos coming up very, very soon indeed. I am now going to give my match score prediction for this one, and I am going to be confident too. I think these players now, they've been rested, they've got their mojo back a little bit, they'll want to give Iniesta that fantastic
fantastic send-off that he deserves in this final, and we will want to win this for the fourth consecutive year. I'm going to go with Barcelona 3, Sevilla 1 on the night. We can penetrate Sevilla's defence, no doubt about that. Messi and Suarez in this one, fully rested and fully ready to go. Barca 3, Sevilla 1, we can win this final. We can win the Copa del Rey. Leave your thoughts and your predictions down below, guys. I will see you soon for more videos. But until then, as always, Visca el Barça!